barko ng Republika ng Pilipinas, Antonio Luna FF-151, is the newest missile-capable frigate of the Philippine Navy and is part of the government's modernization program for the armed forces of the Philippines. National Defense and Hyundai Heavy Industries from the Republic of Korea. After more than 3 years of production and coordination, BRP Antonio Luna FF-151 successfully entered Philippine waters in February.
Oh my God, if I die, I'm a legend. When they lay me down to rest, I know I was always prepping. Oh my God, my whole life.
The bridge is located on the upper portion of the ship. The commanding officer, or skipper, can give his orders from here to be executed by the crew all around the vessel. This brand new frigate is equipped with sophisticated technology capable of performing a multitude of functions in support to the Philippine Navy's. The SAM deck is short for the surface-to-air missile deck. This is where the surface-to-air missiles are located. These missiles are short-ranged, remotely operated, and are designed primarily for anti-air defense. Two surface-to-air missiles are installed on the ship, one on the port side and one on the starboard side. These provide effective defense against all threats. BRP Antonio Luna FF-151 has a flight deck at the tail with the ability to handle a helicopter weighing up to 12 tons. Aside from its warfighting capabilities, FF-151's sensors are equipped to support speed of 25 knots and can travel up to 4,500 nautical miles at a cruising speed of 15 knots. It can also sustain operational presence of up to 30 days and can withstand rough sea conditions up to sea state 7-1. Has officially entered service during the commissioning ceremony held on March 19, 2021. Rest assured that it is modern, multi-capable, and ready to protect our seas.
Unlike previous your torpedoes are activated with saltwater activation.
Ako nga pala si Gunner's Mate 3rd Class Militar in Pulido, Philippine Navy. 76mm Super Rapid Multi-Feeding Gun. Especially, ang pangalan ng ating barrel ay 76mm Super Rapid Multi-Feeding Gun. Na ang dinitin nyo ito para sa anti-air warfare, lalo-lato na sa anti-missile, and then anti-surface. At ginagamit din siya sa naval gun fire support para sa ating ground force na marine at army. Tinanggap itong Super Rapid dahil may kinayaan itong makapagtot ng 120 rounds per minute. Ang ammunition nito o mana ay umaabot sa 15.9 kilometer. Meron din siyang tinatawag na extended range ammunition na umaabot ng 20 kilometer. Tinanggap din natin na multi-feeding ito dahil meron siyang dalawang magazine na ang magazine na ito ay pwede tayo makikita ng 70 round dapat magazine na kahit anong klase ng ammunition pang anti-air o anti-surface pang anti-personnel pwede natin siya ilagay, and then yung system natin or yung operator at pag namili siya or kailangan natin ng anti-air, automatic yung system namimili siya kung ano yung kailangan niyang gagamitin na ammunition. So hindi na natin manually pipiliin kung alin ang gagamitin ammunition.
Samantala naman yung mga katropa, ito naman yung asensya 30mm match na pinatawag din na secondary gun ng ating barko ay ginagamit pang surface target and pang air target. Ito rin ay kinokontrol ng operator sa kanyang control console. Okay mga katropa, ngayon nandito na tayo sa surface to air detail natin. I-discuss ko ngayon yung mga parts ng missile. So una, yung turret. Ito yung turret. Dito malalaman kung saan yung firing sectors niya or angle niya. Training angle and then the elevation angle. Then next naman is yung sa missile launcher natin. So sa missile launcher naman, dito malalaman kung ano ang munition ba yung nakaluot sa kanya, kung ang training ba, kung operational siya or dummy round lang yung sa missile launcher. Sa guidance systems niya naman is passive infrared homing guidance. So ibig sabihin once na makadetect siya ng hit, yung missile na mismo yung papunta doon sa main target. Next naman is yung sa thermal imager, siya naman yung research baka sa tracking and identification ng target. Even